My name is Kendra, and my daughter, Samantha, was born to be an athlete from day one.
Samantha started playing soccer, I believe she was 7, and she was very good at it. She had great instincts. We really bonded over that.
She's always just been very talented. I mean, her freshman year in high school, she made the varsity soccer team.
If I really would have stuck with playing soccer, I probably could have went to college one day, play soccer, maybe have gone pro or coach one day.
You don't kick it with your toe, you either kick it with the side or your laces.
Now, Samantha wakes up and the very first thought, very first movement of the day is, I'm dope sick and I need drugs.
I'm a heroin addict.
The first time I laid eyes on Samantha, she was the most beautiful thing I've ever seen in the whole world. She was the most precious gift I could have ever dreamed of.
Brian was a freshman in college, and Kendra was the same age, so they were very young.
Samantha was conceived on prom night. I was a teen mom. I was only 18 years old when I had Samantha.
We were just too young. Too young to get that started, and of course it failed after just a few years. Samantha was 2.5 when we split.
I would have to say she gravitated towards Brian more. She cherished him. She was definitely a daddy's girl.
They would take trips and go caving. They would do family trips to Hawaii and a lot of thrill-seeking adventures.
Sports were always a pretty big impact on my life, and I'm a pretty natural athlete. I always played soccer and basketball for a lot of years.
Samantha's father was the coach of her youth soccer team, and it was good because it always put a little additional pressure on her to be able to perform during the big games, and she was able to do that.
I just remember being happy all the time.
But she lost it all in one afternoon when the police showed up at the soccer field that day. Samantha's dad had expressed interest in photos of one of Samantha's dearest friends.
The email exchanges were shared with me, and there's no question in my mind that, you know, what I heard seemed inappropriate for an exchange of an adult male and a 12-year-old child.
Why you stopped coaching?
Oh, I'm sure you heard about this from the other side of the family, and I'm sure that this is one of the things you're trying to get to. I made a horrible mistake. I was coach for this team for 3 years, and I was emailing with several of the girls and got pulled into something that was completely stupid and took some things away from me that I can't get back.
And it's sad that it still affects my family to this day and has destroyed us.
It was twisted into something that it wasn't. And no matter, it didn't matter that there was plenty of evidence that I said, you know, we can't email anymore, we can't talk anymore. This, you've got to think about what's right for you. And I kept getting pulled back in, and it was the biggest mistake of my life by a long shot.
He got cut out of my life pretty hard, even by me and the community. He wasn't even allowed on the same school grounds I went to or any of the soccer places we went to.
And now she also was having these issues of trying to deal with her friends, with the betrayal of what her father had done with her friends.
She lost her soul.
It's almost like I feel like people look at me differently, I guess, just not even for my own decisions.
By the time she was 16, the only thing that she had any ambition for was sex and drugs.
It wasn't long after that she was trying to figure out ways that she could make means to live.
I have a question for you.
What?
Do you have herpes?
No.
Do you have warts?
No.
Do you have anything?
I have hepatitis.
You can't catch that from having sex, can you?
No, it's from needles.
Okay.
Did you know that you can get hep C through sex?
No.
I think Samantha's right now is in serious denial about the lifestyle of what she's living.
And it went from just being bad to where it's dreadful right now.
Hi, how are you? I'm Ken.
I ain't okay with this.
Nice to meet you.
No way.
For a few minutes?
Every single one of you left me on the streets for the last 2 years. Now all of a sudden you all want to come back to my life? Every single one of you has.
We left you on the streets or you chose the streets?
I chose the streets over you because all you did was put me down. All you did was put me down. Tammy didn't do. You just left my life years ago.
This will be the last time I guarantee I speak to any one of you because that's the way this intervention works.
Samantha, I'm here today because I believe in you and I love you. I believe that you're strong and brave and can beat your addiction. Nobody in this room has failed you more than me. We were so tight.
You were my best friend.
I know. We were so tight for years and years, and I made a huge mistake and altered your life. If I could go back and change one thing in my life, that would be it, because I truly believe that we wouldn't be here today.
We wouldn't.
Will you please go get help so that we can all see this Samantha here again?
My dearest pretty princess, I'm here today because you're my best friend, and I need you very much to be a part of my everyday life. You make me feel complete when it's me, you, and Kennedy, when I know we're all home and safe, and I enjoy all our togetherness. And I'm sorry that I failed you. And I will do anything I can to make it back up to you. You are so special. And I just can't let you go down and be a statistic. You can do whatever you put your mind to. Please get help for all of us. I need you, please.
Apparently you don't.
We want you to get your help right now.
No, I ain't going right now. I said no 20 times already.
It's not done yet. They're not done.
Sammy, stay here.
Go get her.
No more contact. It's over.
I know it's a tough road. I know it's a hard decision. All it takes is one step.
Let's go, Samantha. That's it.
And you come back.
What, for 90 days for me to get sober, and then at the end of the 90 days, I'll be right back to where I'm at. I'll figure out how to get dope in Arizona. I'll figure out how to get dope in Arizona. I don't give a f-.
You'll hear from me tomorrow, Sammy.
Don't worry about it.
We love you, Samantha.
You'll hear from me tomorrow, every day.
They told me you were really doing some amazing work there.
Yeah, I haven't had urges in like probably at least 2 to 3 weeks now. And that's just amazing to me to not even have those things cross my mind. I don't even have to fight the monkey on my shoulder like the way I used to.
Good job. I love hearing that.